Honogotchi is an artificial intelligence-powered Wi-Fi handshake capturer that runs conveniently on a Raspberry Pi Zero. Now, I'm pretty excited to show it off to you guys, because not often do I come across something as inventive and slightly random as this. So the project runs on a Raspberry Pi Zero W, that's the one with Wi-Fi. Along with that, it uses an e-paper display hat, which does mean some soldering is involved to take advantage of the Pi's 40-pin header. Considering I used lead-free solder, I think I did a pretty decent job. Now, the name Honogotchi obviously stems from Tamagotchi. Remember those? Tamagotchis were these digital pets you'd look after, feeding them, taking care of them, etc. If you went to school in the 90s, early noughties, you probably remember the plight of them getting confiscated in class, just hoping they wouldn't die before the end of school. So a Honogotchi is similar. However, instead of having to manually feed him some form of digital food every half hour, he feeds off Wi-Fi. The idea being he's constantly on the hunt for Wi-Fi handshakes. He can get those handshakes either through passive sniffing or by actively deauthenticating clients on the network and waiting for them to reconnect. You can see the number of handshakes he's captured, the number of networks he's pwned in the bottom left there. The more Wi-Fi you feed him, the happier he'll get. He literally has facial expressions. Though if you leave him idling for too long without any Wi-Fi handshakes, then I do think at some point he will actually start crying. And when I say feed him Wi-Fi, I just mean carry him around and let him discover networks as he goes. Thankfully, he isn't as involved as the original Tamagotchis. But anyway, the twist is that he's powered by AI. So he tunes his own parameters over time to maximize the amount of WPA crackable material that he'll capture. So he'll start off as a Wi-Fi pwning noob, but give him time and he should become somewhat of a maestro. And just so we're clear, Honogotchi doesn't crack Wi-Fi passwords, he doesn't hack Wi-Fi networks in any way at all. All he'll do is capture Wi-Fi handshakes and store them as PCAP files, giving you the freedom to do with them what you will. It's up to you what you do. If you've watched this channel for any length of time, you'll know what the four-way handshake is by now. But in essence, the four-way handshake is just the communication performed when a device connects to a Wi-Fi network. So if you capture that communication, you are essentially capturing a hashed version of the Wi-Fi password, which you can then go on to brute force and try and figure out later on. So back to Honogotchi, because there is a lot to say here. By default, he'll use the Pi's internal 2.4 GHz antenna, which is great for convenience, though you do of course have the option to mod your Pi and solder on an external antenna connector, which you can then connect up to an external antenna. I do have a video on that, by the way, which I will link down in the description, of course. Alternatively, you can just use a more powerful adapter to begin with. So something like this Alpha one here, which will do 2.4 GHz as well as 5 GHz, because let's not forget, the Pi is limited to just 2.4. In either case, we are just talking about a Raspberry Pi Zero, so you can power him from pretty much anything. A power bank, a wall charger, plugging him into your computer, pretty much anything will do. But I like the idea of using a power bank and taking him on your travels, and then once you return from your epic, you can simply just plug him into your PC and SSH into him and grab those PCAP files he's captured with those handshakes. So let's take a quick look at the Honogotchi.ai website, because it is really well done. There's even a pwn map which shows off all the newborn Honogotchis and their locations. But first, the documentation is really pretty extensive. There's a wealth of information on how to set up and configure your Honogotchi, as well as the details on all those extra plugins available. Maybe there's a topic for another video. There's a list of all the faces Honogotchi can express, which IMO makes this probably the most ridiculous Wi-Fi pwning tool I've ever seen. But ridiculous in a good way, because pwning Wi-Fi can get old real quick. Having something like this injects a certain kind of fun into something which seems pretty mundane. Honogotchi is made to run on a Pi Zero W, however, you can apparently get it to work on a Pi 3 or 4. Additionally, it uses an e-ink display. The advantage of using e-ink is that they're pretty low power consumption, as they only really draw current when the screen is updated. Also, when power is removed, hey presto, the last display state is preserved. The only real downsides being that you do get a bit of ghosting, oh, and there isn't any backlight. Something else I thought I'd mention is that Ponagotchis, like Tamagotchis, can make friends. If another Ponagotchi is in range of your Ponagotchi, he'll get all flustered and, well, I don't really know what happens after that, because I've only got one, but hopefully it's nothing too NSFW. So this video is more of an overview, a first look at Ponagotchi, if you will. If you do want a tutorial on how to set the thing up, get it working, then do let me know down in those comments. I will say setup was mostly straightforward. However, if you do want to set up things like plugging it into your computer, getting that SSH working, there is a bit of, there are a few strings to pull in that case. But if you are interested in that setup video, let me know down in those comments. But before I leave you, I need to explain why this little thing is the best thing since sliced bread, I don't know. Anyway, this is Malduino. He's a bad USB. The idea being, you write scripts that go on his microSD card, then when you plug him in, he'll type out those scripts at lightning speed, like a super fast automatic keyboard. The point? Well, it's not too difficult to write a script that opens up a command prompt, and then oof, well, the computer is your oyster. He's powered by Arduino, so truly hackable. Check out the link in the description to my own site, maltronics.com, where you can learn more. So thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll leave those links for the Ponagotchi website in the description. So if you want to give it a go yourself before I do my tutorial video, then you're free to do that. If you're wondering what to watch next, I recently made a video on Anonymous. Where did they go? Why haven't we heard from them in recent years? I'll leave that video somewhere here. I think that's how it works. So yeah, thanks for watching and stay tuned for more hacking videos. Have a good one.